Excellencies, I join you in commending Secretary General Antonio Guterres and the Honorable Justin Trudeau, Prime Minister of Canada, and Honorable Andrew Holness, Prime Minister of Jamaica, for this initiative on financing for development in the era of COVID-19 and beyond. My country, Guyana, is persuaded of the pressing need to pursue collectively a comprehensive and multifaceted approach to effectively combat the COVID-19 pandemic and to secure a path towards sustainable recovery. The COVID-19 pandemic, already a dire health emergency, is an unpending economic crisis, reversing decades of development, derailing progress towards the attainment of the Sustainable Development Goals, and intensifying poverty and inequality. The pandemic is worsening unemployment and weakening health and education systems. As a consequence, developing countries are expected in the near term to experience widening fiscal deficits, the narrowing of fiscal space, reduced external financing inflows, and increasing debt. Small states with undiversified economies and limited resources will find it difficult to satisfy their immediate development and recovery needs. The United Nations is the world's foremost multilateral organization. It must spearhead the global response to this pandemic. At a health level, the response should involve increased access to personal protection equipment for frontline health workers, the provision of therapeutics and equipment for patient treatment, and the rollout of and support for mass immunization when a vaccine becomes available. On the socioeconomic front, it is imperative that global resources be mobilized to ensure a return to a sustainable development trajectory. Resources must be made available expeditiously using a variety of financial mechanisms, including debt relief, debt service moratoriums, concessional financing, and capitalization of deferred interest payments and grants. Mr. President, these measures will facilitate developing states' recovery. The pandemic, however, has highlighted and exacerbated global and social inequalities. Addressing these inequalities must become integral to the global and national responses. In this regard, I applaud the sentiments expressed by the United Nations Secretary General in this year's Mandela Lecture. The Secretary General has clearly set out the challenges which lay before us and the actions which are necessary. His call for a new social contract and a new global deal is an apt response to both the pandemic and the inequalities which exacerbate its effects. A new global deal, as envisioned by the Secretary General, will allow for the effective transfer of resources, financial, intellectual, and technological, to developing countries. It will facilitate also a fairer sharing of the benefits of globalization. A new social contract, in turn, will ensure the effective use of these resources to ensure that states remain on a sustainable development trajectory. Mr. President, I'm confident that the world will defeat this pandemic. I'm confident also that with the political will, we can reduce global and social inequalities. It is important, therefore, that as we recover and rebuild, that we initiate a new era, one characterized by a world where we anticipate and prevent illness instead of scrambling to cure them, a world where every child receives a quality education, a world where our elderly enjoy a dignified life, a world where everyone has access to food, healthcare, housing, and water, and a world in which diversity and human rights are respected. Establishing the new era in global relations will require significant development support, more so now in the face of an impending global recession. For many small states, the burden of recovery from the pandemic will be too great to bear on their own. It is therefore of paramount importance that today's deliberations pave the way for financial support to help small states rebound from the COVID-19 pandemic. It is equally vital that the Secretary General's call for a new global deal, a new social contract, be pursued with promptness to ensure the recovery is aligned to reducing inequalities. Mr. President, these proposals represent a way forward to a positive COVID-19 era response. It is our responsibility to ensure the future is one of prosperity and equality. We have survived pandemics, global wars, and recessions before. We shall survive again. And as the United Nations usher in the new, a new era, I thank you.